Hello everyone, welcome back to Fixing with the Kid. Today I'm working on my Stihl 034 AV. And yeah, this is an oldie. You know how you can tell it's old? Because it says made in West Germany. This saw is actually from 1986. And the problem I'm having with it is, I'll show you. Does your chainsaw leave a puddle? Well, this one is. So I think I know what's wrong with it, so we're going to get into it and start dissecting it. But I do want to talk a little bit about this saw. This is the first Stihl chainsaw that I've owned. I didn't, of course, have it new. This was given to me. I had made a statement that one day I'd like to have a Stihl chainsaw, and within a day or two, somebody brought me this saw. And when I got it, I was very excited to get this saw. I didn't know what was wrong with it. They told me that it has been sitting for a long period of time. And I was like, well, I'm glad to have it. So you have to take this little clip off to take the clutch off. So I've got that. Let me zoom you in a little bit. So then you have this washer and you have your clutch. I'm going to pull that off. It's got a little burr right here. We'll get that off. So anyway, he gave it to me. He said the problem is it doesn't run. There we go. It doesn't run, and told me he didn't know why it wouldn't run, but I'd have to fix it, but it was mine. So anyway, what had happened was when it came in, it was all this, it floats. This to the anti-vibration, so it floats. And so where it separates right here was twisted, and someone had dropped it out of a tree. So what had happened was, when they dropped it out of a tree, it had landed, and I got it running, pushed it back in, pushed the grommets back in, and got it running. But as it was running, you could set it on the table, you could start it, and it ran great. And as soon as you picked it up off the table, it would quit. So you'd start it again, leave it on the table, it would run great, sit there and idle. As soon as you picked it up, it would quit. And in between the carburetor and the block is a rubber boot, and when it fell, it ripped the rubber boot. So it's fine as long as it's sitting on the table, but as soon as I picked it up, it would open up the gap in the boot, it would suck air, and it would quit. So mystery solved. All right, so what we need to do with it leaving a puddle, this is not my go-to saw. It's a very aggressive saw. I'll show you the chain a little bit later. What's happening is underneath is the tube that takes it from the tank to the oiler. And what's happened is the tube has gotten old, and it's allowing the oil in the tank to drip out. So I'm going to start pulling some of it apart, and we'll get into it. I'm going to pull the clutch, and we'll be able to see the oiler. This takes a 3/4 socket. It should be reverse threads. There we go. Tightening it is loosening it. All right, so inside here, let me zoom in. Inside here is our oil pump. This is the oil pump. This is the line that runs out, and the oil comes out this hole right here. And the bottom of it here, there's a tube that comes out from the bottom of the saw, goes into this tube. So, okay, I took off the little cover here. I wanted you to see here is the port that runs down behind here and connects to the oil pump. And this is where your bar oil comes out. I took the cover plate off. I'm trying to get this separated so I can get in there to that hose.
Right, somewhere along the way we lost audio, but I'll try to talk you through what's going on. So here's the oil pump. I tried to we got to remove it. So what we're going to do is we're going to pull out these two screws that are right there on either side of the shaft there. We're going to take those out as I just did, and then the oil pump will come out. Down on the bottom right where I've got my finger pointed, that's where it connects to the tube that runs into the tank. So we want to pull the oiler out so we can access the tube. The tube is in the bottom right corner of that hole there underneath that circular thing. So we're going to pull the oil pump out. Found out why it was hard to get out. Someone had siliconed it together. Put a little bit of RTV silicone. There it is. Siliconed it to the tube. So now you can see that's where it connects to the tube that runs into the tank. And there's the tube. You can see the oil coming out of it. So you have to pop that out and replace it. So what happens is the tube over time becomes rigid and it doesn't seal like it should to the oil pump. And as you set the saw down, it just seeps and weeps around it. So let me get this tube out of here. As you can see, the oil line is full of oil. I've got it out, get it where you can see it. There it is. You can see it has a filter on the end of it. And the filter just pushes on the end of it. Like I said, the longer this tube sits in there, the more rigid it becomes. It becomes difficult. The new one is a lot more pliable. Okay, here it is. And then you've got the part that clips into the tank. It also becomes less pliable, so the oil, as it shrinks, the oil can leak out around it. Here's the old oil line, and that's the part that goes into the oil pump. Here's the new one. Here's the new one. There's the part number. So we're going to take it out and see how they compare. What happens to these oil lines is they get stiff. This one is a lot more flexible. This one on the right is a lot more flexible than this one. And if you look here in the center, you can see how the hole is elongated compared to the new one. And that's how it seals. This stuff gets rigid and it won't seal up. This one's really flexible. So I'm just going to put it back together. I got to put the oil filter on the end of this and we'll drop it back in the tank. Okay, got the oil filter on the new one. Let's get it put back in the tank. All right, so I'm just going to drop it in. It's got to go that way. Get it down in there. And then push it, get the grommet to go back in without damaging it. All right, and then there's a groove at the bottom. There's a groove at the bottom. You can see where my finger's at. There's a groove, and then there's a little tab on the oil line, and it lines up right there with it. So I'll show you on this one. So you see the tab right here on the oil line. It lines up in, I'll try to zoom in for you, lines up in this groove so you make sure you get it the orientation correctly. Then I'm just going to take the oil pump, get it back down in there. Back in here the way it's supposed to be. There we go. Now that locks right in there like that. So one there, one there. want to over tighten it. I've got some torque. I've got a torque wrench, Torx screwdriver. Tighten it by hand. You want to get it tight so that the oil pump fits snugly inside the rubber grommet of the oil line we just put in. But you don't want to strip out the screws. So if you use an impact, make sure you slow down before you bottom it out so you don't strip it out or break it. All right, so now we have our needle bearings. I've got a small tube of grease. Just going to take the needle bearings, run that grease, roll them around in those needle bearings. Then you're going to place that right there. Then, as I said, you want to find out where the arm is on the worm gear. It's right here. So you want to make sure that you take the clutch drum, make sure that your brake is disengaged. You want to find it and line it up. So it's right there. I want to line it up. You want to make sure you line that up, because I have seen them where people didn't line it up and they just let the clutch run on top of it. It actually will grind that little tab off. All right, so now we have our chain sprocket. We have our washer and we have our clip. Get you a pair of pliers, wear eye protection. Make sure the clip is locked back in there. Now I took a few things off of here, checking out some other things. Let me put that back together. So that plugged back in. And while you've got it apart, clean your air filter. Take this air filter out, take it outside, and blow it off. This is a well-built saw, not like the junk they make today. So that's pretty plugged. I'm gonna go ahead and clean it. I'll bring you right back. Okay. I blew most of the sawdust off of it. Probably need to get a new one. I'm not using this saw a lot right now, so make sure you don't have any sawdust past the filter. Get that reinstalled. It is locked. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put the cover back on. I'm going to clean my workbench. I'm going to make sure it has plenty of bar and chain oil in it. And I'm going to let it sit on a piece of cardboard on my workstation for a day or two. And we'll see if it still leaks. All right, everybody. I filled it up all the way to the top with bar oil. And I've let it sit here a couple of days. And no puddle. A couple of residue from the bottom where it was sitting, but no leakage. So it's fixed. It's a great saw. It's an old saw, but that's back when they made them well. So, hope this helps somebody. Have a great day. Goodbye.